you know, looking okay, but many people hide what they're going through. When you see a person's face, they might be bubbly, smiling, and so on. You don't know the pain that they're going through in their hearts. And therefore, when she made this video, she actually mentioned a few things. It was good that she mentioned a few things because we can actually address this matter. She was exploited as a daughter-in-law and as a wife. She was actually abused to the degree that she felt there is no way out. Her family couldn't do much because of culture. Her in-laws and her husband, according to her, kept on demanding from her every single thing, more than she could actually manage, according to her. So what was the problem? The problem is, when we get married as Muslims, the boy is supposed to give the girl, the groom is supposed to give the bride what is known as a mahr. Mahr is a gift of whatever, whatever she demands, whatever she asks, whatever her family would like. And he needs to assume responsibility of three basic things as a minimum: food, clothing, and accommodation. He needs to provide for her a place, he needs to give her food, he needs to make sure that she is dressed and she has clothing. That's the minimum he must assume responsibility of. If a man cannot afford that much, he should not get married. The Prophet ﷺ says, يَا مَعْشَرَ الشَّبَابَ مَنِ اسْتَطَاعَ مِنْكُمُ الْبَاءَةَ فَلْيَتَزَوَّجْ. Whoever from amongst you, O youth, is able and capable to assume the full responsibilities of marriage, get married. If you can't do that, you cannot get married. Unless obviously you have someone helping you, like your father or your folks, that would be okay. But when we have, because of a culture we're following that is against the Islamic teaching, imposed on the bride to pay money to get married, so the dowry comes the other way around, un-Islamic, unacceptable. What happens, we say the girl has to come up with the house, the car, her entire salary. She must serve the husband's entire family. She must come up with the furniture, the clothing, everything else. And on top of that, she must be smiling all the time and be at the beck and call of the whole tribe. And she must be okay with that. That's un-Islamic. That's prohibited. That is what caused what Aisha did. And that is haram. Let's never blame Islam for something that Islam has prohibited, and people have done it who may have been Muslim. But that culture needs to be addressed and it needs to be modified, because it is wrong.